And now we go directly to Sharm el-Sheikh to join Mohammed al-Shaban. Good evening, Mohammed.
Good evening, Esther.
Mohammed, can you give us an update on the Arab League summit? What's happening the latest?
Yes, Esther, I'm currently outside the Sharm el-Sheikh Congress and Conference Center, where the Arab leaders convened this morning for the opening session and followed by the first open session for the 26th Arab League Summit. Now, there were a number of opening remarks in the opening ceremony. They primarily focused on strengthening Arab unity and solidarity. Of course, the Yemeni issue was the most prominent, with the third day of air strikes led by the Saudi-led coalition of Arab forces on the Houthi rebels in Yemen. The Egyptian president, Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, expressed his support for this move. He also supported the draft resolution submitted by the Arab foreign ministers on Thursday of establishing a joint Arab force. The custodian of the two holy mosques, His Majesty King Salman bin Abdulaziz Al Saud, also stressed that his fight, or the Saudi-led coalition fight against the Houthi rebels, will continue until stability and security is restored to the legitimate government and legitimate people of Yemen. Now, the Yemeni president was also present during the opening ceremony. He expressed his how he had to go through a number of obstacles to get here. He expressed his extreme gratitude to the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, to the GCC countries and the Arab countries taking part in this military offensive against the Houthi rebels. It is noteworthy also, Esther, that this summit was attended or is attended by the UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon. If this indicates anything, it indicates the importance of this summit due to the challenges facing the region at the time being and the possible repercussions of these challenges on the global arena. Ban Ki-moon expressed his concern over what is happening in Yemen. He expressed his concern about the Syrian situation, the situation in Lebanon with regards to the Syrian refugees, and he also stressed that Israel needs to end its occupation and its illegal activities, illegal settlement activities in Palestine, and go back to the negotiating table. It is clear, Esther, that this summit is taking a different direction compared to other summits. The feel is more decisive in this summit. The Arab leaders are here, and the stance is basically we need to work together and achieve more solidarity and fight the challenges that we are facing. The summit marks 70 years since the establishment of the Arab League in 1945 and is working under the slogan, working towards further joint Arab solidarity. Back to you, Esther.
And Mohammed, do we have any more meetings lined up in the next day or two?
Yes, we're expecting the closing session to be tomorrow, late afternoon, early evening. There is a session about to start later tonight, and then there's one tomorrow morning. These are closed sessions, but the final closing session will be an open session where the resolutions will be read out, followed by a press conference. We'll be getting more details about what the leaders have arrived at, basically.
Thank you, Mohammed, and we look forward to your updates over the next day. And that was our correspondent, Mohammed al-Shaban, reporting live from the Arab League summit in Sharm el-Sheikh.